What is up? I Love Basketball TV. I'm Coach Ryan Rizuki, and today we're going to talk about how to score and how to handle tight pressure with really, really aggressive defenders. So the number one thing we got to understand when we're playing aggressive defenders is that we don't want to panic. The more in control that we can stay, the better that we can be on the court. We want to have our head on a swivel, be able to see the floor so we can make our passes, to see our scoring options, to see the help side and our teammates. And we want to make sure that we can handle the pressure and still do what we need to do on the floor. So the number one mistake I see when pressure happens is that the offensive player with the ball starts to step or lean away from the pressure. So if I have a really aggressive defender coming at me, a lot of players start to step back, put the ball here, and they're almost in this position of fear. Now that's the number one thing we can't do. We got to make sure that when that pressure comes, we are wide so we can own up all of this space and that we are have no issues and no problem creating contact. So if that defender starts to come up to me and starts to pressure me, of course, number one, let's keep the ball away, right? I don't want to have the ball in this space here. I want to make sure that the ball is away and I can use my hips here to kind of step into them and stay wide, right? I can protect the ball here, I can protect the ball here, anywhere. But now the number one thing is I just want to try to create as much space as possible because I own this space as an offensive player. So we'll look at three jabs to begin. I can go ahead and jab into them, number one, right? Pressuring them, pushing them off of me, creating some space. So now I can own that space and then play there and see my passing options and my scoring options. Next, we can create some separation by stepping across and pretending like we're gonna drive over there. So maybe I'm here, maybe I'm here and I wanna drive. I don't need to necessarily go. I could dribble with it, I don't have to dribble with it, but I need to just sell either into them or across to make them drop their feet. And of course, the last one, if we do have the space, sell that jab to this side. So now that I've got my jabs down, I'm allowing that defense to back up off me and forcing them to back up off me because now I'm pressuring them, showing them that even though they're too high on me and too close to me, I can still drive past them. So either I create space or I make them back up or I make them back up. Once I create that reaction, defense drops and now I'm in a position to succeed versus doing this, where they can now get into my space and I'm lost. So I definitely don't want to do that off the triple threat. Now when we play off the bounce, they're of course going to keep one or two hands on me, whatever the ref will allow and however aggressive that they're going to be, right? They're going to try to get up in our grill, make sure they're as close as possible to us, have a lot of reaching going on, but sometimes the ref will allow all that contact. And sometimes if you're scared and you don't know how to be aggressive towards that contact, they can go ahead and get some steals, pressure you, force your turnovers. So we've already talked about how we can go ahead and handle that in our triple threat scenario. But let's say we're coming down the floor, we're trying to go score on the other side, or we have it in the half court, and we're just looking, we already have our live dribble. Now when they pressure us, one, I want to put my body in a position where I can go ahead and protect the ball away, right? I don't want to show the ball. So I have that ball protected, but I'm still a threat. I don't want to be that player who has to continue to turn to protect the ball because now I can't see the floor, I don't have scoring options, and I don't have passing options. So oftentimes I'll see when players start to handle pressure, they'll turn here, here, but they're not going anywhere because they can't see the floor. So I want to be in this position where I can still move forward. I can go this way, I can change and go this way, but I can now handle some pressure because I'm wide, but I'm still long and I'm forward. So this hand here, when that defense tries to pressure me, I can one, just pin their hand away, or two, swipe it away. As long as you don't push them, and as long as I don't hold them. Now I don't have an offensive foul, but if they put a hand on me, I absolutely can just take the hand off. And when you watch Kyrie, there's some amazing clips and some amazing videos of Kyrie coming down the floor, and of course the defense can't run with Kyrie, they can't handle him, so they have their hands all over him. That's the only way that they can slow him down. And you watch him dribble and he looks like this, off me. Off me, he keeps pushing the hand off of him every single time. Anybody put a hand on Kyrie, he's immediately taking it off. That's one of the big things that he does as a ball handler to really control not only his body, not only the ball in his hands, but to also control the defense. And there are always going to be those three levels of control. Can you control the ball, making ball handling moves? Can you control your own body, your footwork? And can you control your defense? And that third level is where a lot of players struggle, to control that defense. The ball is the easiest. Doing simple, basic, stationary moves, that's the easiest. Your own body is tough too. being able to get your steps to the right spots, to where you need to get to. But then the hardest of them all, which only the elite players can do, is to control your defender. And you only have to do that on a small scale. You don't have to do it at an elite level where you're like Chris Paul and hold people behind you, where you can go ahead and manipulate and bump them and move them and do all the things you need to do. Because sometimes they are bigger and taller and stronger than you, but as long as you can control your own space, you can survive. So now, if they put a hand on me, like I said, we take it off. And we move that thing off. And once I get past them, I'm never gonna hook them, but I can go ahead and bump them, or I can go ahead and pin them to get past. So now, I'm facing forward, defense is pressuring me, so I'm here, protected. I can go ahead and turn, nothing wrong with that, but I just don't wanna play with my back too much. So I'm controlling pressure, they put a hand on me, get it off. They try to steal the ball, I can spin. They come here, I can jab at them and change, but now I can put them a little bit more on their heels because I'm playing cool, calm, and collected, and I can go ahead and change my speeds now. So then, that's the next one. We're able to change our speeds and kind of stunt at them a little bit. I can get them to back up the same way as we jab. I can get them to back up. I can force them to create a reaction where now they're worried about my drive, and I'm no longer worried about their pressure. So good ball handlers, they can play off stunts and really force that defense to back up a little bit, because now I'm making it known that I'm a threat off the bounce. So they can't touch me, and when their hands are off, I'm stunting, so now they're backing up, giving me room to get to the spots that I need to get to. Now I can play slow, I can play fast. You can also start to play high, play low. I can stay here or play here, real high and real low. But that forces them to start to change their stances. And then I can get to where I need to on the floor. So we put together a drill for you to start to work on some of this stuff. And we're gonna start in the triple threat. Now from here, I can place down two cones or two shoes or two place markers that will allow me to have my feet and their feet emulated. So when I go ahead, I'm gonna start with one, jab across, two, jab into them, and then three, jab outside. So I'm really forcing them to get off me, create some space, and then sell them before I drive. And you can change that order depending on the space you have. So maybe I start one, two, three, and then go the next way. But now I'm more of a threat and really forcing them to back off of me instead of allowing them to take up my space. So let's start here. I'm gonna start with the inside through the middle. There's one, a crossbody, two, and then jab here, and then drive. So every time we're getting three jabs and then we drive. So this time, let's start by selling them across. So they're here, tight on it, bang, get them one, open up two, they get close, get off me, and then rip them. But as long as we get our three jabs, then we can play. And this is showing you just to play patient. You see, I'm not rushing. So maybe now I start here, they're close to us, get them off, get into them, across, and drive. So off the bounce, we can start with this bounce here and do the same thing, we jab. Jab, jab, and then we can attack. Whether I'm right hand, left foot, or right foot, or sorry, right hand and left foot, but really selling on those jabs to really start to shift my body. Now I'm not so worried about my handle, because even if I'm not that great of a ball handler and I can't do all this, I can still sell jab, across, here, here. I can still get them off me while just taking normal dribbles. And I get to change my speed, because I can slow to go, go, here, go. So I'm starting left hand, one, two, change. One, two, three, change. And I can go ahead and mix those up. One, change. One, two, three, go. The cool part about this is you don't even need great handles. You just gotta have good footwork.